Welcome to this .NET MAUI ListView Control tutorial. The Syncfusion .NET MAUI ListView Control allows you to swipe items for actions, such as archiving and deleting messages. Now let's create an Outlook style inbox using the .NET MAUI ListView Control. In this video, I will show you how to enable swiping in a list view. I will also explain how to set up swipe actions for archiving and deleting messages, and how to display a pop-up notification with an undo option. Now let me open an existing MAUI application, where I have already imported the Syncfusion.NET MAUI ListView namespace. Here I have configured the Syncfusion.NET MAUI ListView to show an Outlook style inbox with a list of mail content. I have created a class called InboxInfo to hold email details such as the sender's name, profile image, subject, and more. Additionally, I have defined a ViewModel class to manage and populate the email data. Look here, I have customized the list view control with an item template and used a grid layout to display profile images, sender names, message subjects, descriptions, and icons for attachments and important messages. If you want to learn how to add the .NET MAUI ListView control to your MAUI application, watch the video linked in the YouTube card above or in the description below. Now I will run the application. You can see the ListView controls that have the email list organized in an Outlook-like inbox appearance. To enable swiping actions, simply set the Allow Swiping property to true. Here you can swipe the item from left to right or right to left. So, to customize the UI while swiping, I can make use of the Start Swipe Template property while swiping towards the right, and the End Swipe Template property while swiping towards the left. Now I'm going to customize the UI while swiping towards right, so define the Start Swipe Template property with data template. Inside the template, add a grid and set its background to a desired color. Then add a label control and define a text property with a Unicode character to display an icon. Additionally, I also specify the font family to make the difference in the Android and Windows platform during swiping. This icon is already stored in the Resources folder. Next, to customize the text, let me set a desired color to the Text Color property and position it at center in both horizontal and vertical direction. Then I also set the font attributes to bold and the size to an appropriate value. Similarly, I will create the End Swipe Template property and use the Start Swipe customization setting here. I changed the icon Unicode value alone, because delete icon should be shown while swiping towards left. Now when you swipe the item to the right, you can see the archive icon, and when you swipe the item to the left, you can see the delete icon. To archive and delete the items while swiping, I need to define the swipe ended event. This event will be called when the swipe gesture ends. Next, let me set the appropriate value for the swipe offset property to specify the minimum distance required for a swipe action. I navigate to the event handler method. In this method, check whether the swipe offset is less than or equal to 100. If so, this method exits early. Next, I go to the ViewModel class to add properties for archive and delete message collections. So let me create a property for the archive messages collection, which returns and set the value of archive messages and raises the property changed event. Similarly, create properties named delete command, archive command, and is deleted. Next, I create a method to handle the item to be deleted. This method takes an object parameter that contains information about the item to be deleted. Next, cast the item object to an inbox info type and assign it to list view item. Then check if the index of list view item is present in the inbox infos and remove it. Similarly, create a method to handle the item to be archived and call the onDelete and onArchive methods in the constrictor. Next, I go to the swipeEnded event handler method. Check whether the swipe direction is right. If it is true, the archive command is executed and the swiped item is passed as a parameter. Suppose the swipe direction is left, the delete command is triggered and the swiped item is passed as a parameter. As a result, when you swipe an item to the right, you will see that the message gets archived. Whereas when you swipe it to the left, you will see that the message gets deleted. Next, let's proceed to see how to display a pop-up message when the action is performed. First, I start by navigating to the ViewModel class. Then, I create a property called PopUpText to store the text that will be shown in a pop-up notification when the swipe action is performed. Next, let me set up an undo command so that I can quickly reverse any action I have taken in the UI. I navigate to the onDelete method, set the pop-up text to deleted, then update a flag to indicate that an item has been deleted. Next, let me add a delay to keep the pop-up visible for a while. Once the delay is completed, reset the isDeleted flag. Similarly, add a pop-up message for archived items. To undo the archiving or deletion of items, let me create an onUndo method. Within this method, I reset the flag to restore the deleted item. Then check if there is an item available to undo the deletion. If the item is present, reinsert it back into its original position in the inbox. Next, check the archive messages for any items with a name that matches the list view item, and store the matches in archived item. Further, check if the item exists in the archive. If it is, remove it from the archive collection and make sure that only the first matching item is removed, stopping the loop after that. Finally, reset the list view item and clear the undo item reference to indicate no item is left to undo. Then call the onUndo method in the constrictor. Now I go to the main page XAML to create a frame control. Then set appropriate values to the corner radius, margin, padding, and height. The frame aligns to the bottom when I specify the vertical options as end. Then bind the visibility of the frame to the isDeleted property of the binding context, ensuring that the frame will be visible only when isDeleted is true. Next, I create a grid layout to organize the child elements in rows and columns. For the grid, let me specify the desired height and a color for the background. Then define the structure of the columns within the grid. To display the notification message, let me add label control and bind its text to the pop-up text property. I customize the appearance of the label by giving appropriate value to the text color, font size, vertical options, vertical text alignment, margin, and character spacing. Similarly, customize a label control to display the undo text. Next, I define a gesture recognizer for the label, then add a tap gesture recognizer, allowing it to respond to user interactions. After that, let me bind the command property to undo command in the view model. Now I run the application. When you swipe an item to the right, it disappears, and a pop-up shows with the text archived on the left and undo on the right. When I click undo, the item is restored to its original position. On the other hand, swiping an item to the left makes it disappear with a pop-up showing the text deleted on the left and undo on the right. When I click undo, the item gets back to its original position. Let's wrap up this video. You learned how to enable swiping in a Syncfusion.NET MAUI list view. You also saw how to create an Outlook-style swipe feature that allows you to archive and delete messages. Additionally, you have learned how to include a pop-up notification for both archiving and deleting actions, along with an undo option. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also included a link where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI controls. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.